Let us see the numericals from today's class. So in the previous class also we done some of the numericals related to rectifiers. Now this question says a crystal diode having the internal resistance RF. See, this is the RF. The internal resistance we can call will be equal to 20 ohm is used for half wave rectification. If the applied voltage is, that is nothing but your V in, that is the meaning of that, right? The applied voltage VI, that is input, is equal to 50 sine omega t. And load resistance RL is equal to 800 ohm. So now what we'll do, we need to find out these terms, that is IM, IDC, IRMS. That is nothing but next, second, you have to find out the AC power input and DC power output. Third one is you have to find a DC output voltage. Fourth one is efficiency. So here the given of rectifier is, which rectifier? The given rectifier is half a rectifier. Okay, so now what we'll do, let us start to solve one by one. Okay, first, so the half a rectifier has RF, that is internal, this is like an internal resistance normally. So like it is like in your diagram, if I say how it will be in the sense, see the half a rectifier diagram will be like this. So we'll have the winding. Next, we'll have the diode. Next, we'll have the resistance. This is nothing but your RL. Okay, this will be your RL. So here, the input resistance main, here the input side would be there. Say, example, I will say like here. So we have the input resistance here, or I can say here. The RN will be here. Then plus and minus VI. Where the given VI is nothing but what? The given VI is nothing but the input is equal to 50 sine omega t. That is the question they given. But you can see this, you can check with the general expression, that is Vin is equal to I, you know that, that is Vm sine omega t. Where this 50 is nothing but Vm. So from this I can say the Vm is nothing but 50 actually. From the question only I'm saying. The maximum, the output peak voltage. Right. Next, the RF is 20 ohm, RL is 80 ohm. So whatever the derivations we done previously, that is with the inclusion of RL, exclusion of RF only we did. Just wherever the RF is there you need to add the RF also. Like both are will be in series or input resistance. Okay. So now let us start with the numerical. First, we have to find out the first. So this is the given. Now you can see here, V is equal to pi sine omega t. The maximum voltage, the Vm will be 50 m because V is equal to Vm sine omega t, where Vm is 50. That is the maximum peak voltage, they can say Vm. So first, the question is what? You have to find out Im. So as you know, for half a rectifier, Im is equal to Vm by RF plus RL. But we might have studied in the previous year all the formulas we wrote Vm by RL only we said. Just here we are including the internal resistance. So that is just we need to add extra RF. That is enough. RF plus RL. So we know the value of Vm. Vm is 50 divided by the RF is, they given in the question, RF is 20 ohm, RL is 800 ohm. See, why we eliminated in the problem the RF in the sense, normally, as assumption, your RL will be very, very greater than RF normally. That is the reason we are eliminating RF. But in your numerical, if they give RF, you need to include that. So the IM will be 0.061 ampere. That is 61 milliampere. plus. Okay. Next, what you have to do? Second, they asked to calculate IDC. That is a DC current. IDC is equal to, already we know the formula, that is IM by pi, where the IM value is 61 milliampere, then by pi. But this pi value will be, you have to keep in your calculator the values in radians. So 3.14, that value only you have to use. Don't use a degree mode. You have to use radians mode. Next, IRMS. The IRMS will be is equal to IM by 2. So that is nothing but is equal to IM is again 61 milliampere divided by 2 is 30.5 milliampere. So this is for the first subdivision. So now let us go for the second subdivision. So what they ask to calculate in the second subdivision, they ask you to calculate in the second subdivision is AC power input and DC power output. So AC power input in the sense that is P. AC power input, that is P in, they ask you to calculate P in. So power is nothing but what actually it is V into I, or I can say I square R. V into I you can say, or I square R, if it is the input side means that is the RMS voltage, very, very important. So here we chosen the relation as I square R, where the I is nothing but I square means which I you have to choose, that is IRMS. Already we know the value of IRMS. So always you have to keep it in your remember, the input voltage will be called as RMS voltage. Keep it in your mind. Okay, so IRMS the whole square into RF plus RL, where IRMS is nothing but here 30.5 milliampere plus IRMS square, 30.5 milliampere. So here they're given nothing but 30.5 divided by 1000, that is milliampere. This is milliampere into RF value 20 ohm plus it is 800 ohm. So 0.763 watt. So here, let me write I square R. So this only we return here. Next, a DC power input. What is a DC power input? Now AC is fine. Now DC, you have to go into sense. So you have to keep it in mind. IRMS is a AC component. IDC is a DC component. So you have to keep it in mind always. When you're going to calculate for AC, you have to choose IRMS. When you're going to calculate for DC, then you have to choose IDC. This is the two important things you need to know. So the DC power output, because input will be AC, output is DC in the rectifier normally. So I square DC into RL, because the output side, there will not be any feedback resistance. That is RF will not be. That is the reason here we are not included the RF. So IDC will be how much? 19.4 milliampere. Then RL will be 400. So 0.31. Watts. That is for second subdivision we got. Now the third subdivision, they ask you to calculate, what's the term? Next, third you have to calculate third is DC output voltage. DC output on VDC. Correct. That is nothing but VDC. Got to keep. This is nothing but VDC. DC output voltage means VDC. VDC is equal to IDC into RL, because as per the Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So VDC is equal to IDC RL, where RL is not, IDC is nothing but already we know the value. The RL also we know the value. Substitute, we'll get 15.52. You keep it in your remember, always the feedback resistance will come in the input. The output side, you won't get any feedback resistance, only RL will be. Next, fourth. The fourth one is nothing but you have to calculate the efficiency. They ask you to calculate efficiency. That is eta. Then you know, you might have remember. So for half-wave rectifier, the efficiency, how much already we created? It is nothing but 40.1 efficiency. Means that is the maximum efficiency the half-wave rectifier will get. So efficiency rectification is nothing but what actually? It is nothing but, it's like, what is the formula? Eta is equal to PDC, that is DC output power, right? PDC divided by PAC. I hope you remember the formula. PDC by PDAC, that is PDC is nothing but just only PDC, right? This is PDC, power DC power output. This is your ADC, that is AC, PAC. So when you do this, we'll get as 39.5C. We'll get the efficiency as this much only. So this all about this problem. Yes, the question was, so why you ignore R of in calculating IDC? Yes, because good question. So why we ignored while calculating IDC? The reason was the IDC is nothing but will be considered as in the DC means what? It is the output side. So the output side, you won't have the resistance as feedback resistance. We'll have only load resistance. That is the reason we are not including the RF resistance. So that is why here we see the IDC is equal to IM by pi. So you can go check it in a previous you can check it in your previous derivations. What we done, you go and check. So you won't consider IDC is equal to IM by pi, the current, because IDC is equal to, or as per the Ohm's law, what is the Ohm's law actually? I is equal to V by R. IDC is equal to V D C by R L. Even you can use this formula also. Even this also is correct. If you know the value of VDC, you know the value of RL, substitute that, then you check it whether you are getting the same value. You may get. So you can use any formula. IDC, VDC by RL also. You can use R. You can use the IM by pi also. Both are same.
Next problem is, yeah, after rectifier.
After rectifier is used to supply 50 volt DC to a resistive load of 800 ohm. The diode has the resistance of 25 ohm. Calculate how much AC voltage is required. So here they are saying, the after rectifier will be used to supply a 50 volt DC output actually to a resistive load of 800 ohm. So from this, the given data, what are the given data? So we have to write the given data. The given data are, so let me write here, that is used to supply, that is RL. The given RL is nothing but 800 ohm. Yes, next. What is that? Next is given. So VDC they given. That is VDC. So how much is VDC? VDC only is nothing but 50 volt. Next they given diode as a resistance. Diode resistance only I can say RF. Diode resistance mean RF. That is called as RF actually. RF is called as diode resistance will be 25 ohm. Diode resistance is 25 ohm, that is RF. Then RL is 800 ohm. This is the given loads. So what you have to calculate now? You have to calculate. So let us go for the solutions. So now you can see here. So this data already we seen. This three data is given. Now we need to find out what the question is. They ask me to calculate the AC voltage required. That is VI. That is nothing but RVM. We can say how much the input AC voltage is required. So for that, what you will do? We know the data of VDC. With the given data, we can calculate. Let the VM be the maximum value of AL voltage signal. So VDC is equal to IDC into RL, as we know this formula, where IDC is nothing but what? IM by pi into RL will be is equal to, again, the IM by pi, how we can write that? So IM will be is equal to, again, I can say IM is equal to VM by RF plus RL. So I can consider this, right? Then into RL. So just we express in this way. So you have to bring this formulas in your way. So how it will be convenient. So now the given VDC is 50. Then VM only we have to calculate. Actually our question is you have to calculate VM actually. So you need to bring the relation like this. VM by pi into RF is given, RL is given. Yes, into 800 here. So when you do the rearrange this expression, the Vm will be is equal to 162. So we can say the AC voltage, calculate AC voltage equal, that is, hence the AC voltage, the maximum value, 162 value volt is required to supply a 50 voltage DC in the output.
Now let us see the next problem. Now let us see about the pulsar rectifier. The pulsar rectifier uses two diodes. The internal resistance of each diode, the internal resistance of each diode may be assumed as constant at 20 ohm. Internal resistance, that is RF. The transformer RMS secondary voltage from the center tape transformer to each end of secondary is 50 volt. So and the load resistance is 980 ohm. Now here we need to calculate the mean load current and the RMS value of load current. Before that, let us see how this the full wave rectifier will be there. This will be your full wave rectifier with the one dot will be there. So here it should be connected. That is the center tape transformer. Then we'll have diode. Then here we have the one more diode. Both will be connected. Then we'll have the one output resistance. That is RL. Okay. So here we'll have the VI. So here we'll have like this. Plus, minus, plus, minus. Okay. So now the question they ask, the transformer RMS secondary voltage from center tap to each end of secondary is 50 volt. Means this is also 50, then this also 50 each. And the load resistance is how much they said? So this will be 980 ohm. That is RL they given. Okay, so now let us find the mean load current and the RMS load current. Okay, let us see now. See here, the given in our question, the RF is 20 ohm. RF is 20 ohm in our question they given. That is each diode means this diode D1 and this diode D2 both has the input resistance be constant at is 20 ohm. Then RL is 980 they given. Then the maximum AC voltage now out, how it will be, how much it is, the maximum is AC input now in the sense. See here, that is Vm is equal to, that is Vm is equal to, that is Vm. That is Vm is equal to primary voltage 50 into root 2. That is the 50 is nothing but here, because here also 50 is dividing, right? That is what they said. The secondary voltage from center tip to each end of secondary is 50. So this is also 50. This also means 50 into root 2. So that is the formula to calculate the Vm, the maximum. The AC, maximum AC voltage will be 70.7 volt. Now, how much will be maximum load current? The maximum load current, that is Im is equal to, or I can say IL. Im is equal to Vm by the maximum load current at the input. Very, very important. Maximum load current at the input. Vm by RF plus RF. Vm value is given as 70.7. RF is 20. RL is already 980. So 70.7 milliampere. So now from this, let us calculate first the question they given. we need to calculate mean load current. So what is the mean load current? So the mean load current is, calculate the mean load current, that is IDC. That is the meaning of mean load current. That is ID, or I can say average IDC, or we can say the another one more term that is called as I average. I average is equal to 2 times of IM by pi, because this is a full wave rectifier. Keep in mind, if it is half wave means IM by pi, full wave 2 IM by pi, 2 times of IM. IM value already we know. Substitute, we'll get 45 milliampere. Next is RMS value of load current. That is what they asked to calculate. RMS value of load current. RMS value of load current. See, what is the RMS value of load current? That is IRMS. So that is nothing but your RMS value of load current, IRMS only. IRMS will be is equal to IM by root 2. So that will be 70.7 IM value divided by root 2. I will get us 50 milliampere. So this is the solution for this problem. Now we can calculate from this form, right? In the center tape circuit, figure shown in 2, that is a figure here in the sense, which figure means full wave rectifier figure. Let me show that. See, this is the given figure. Yes, so this will be the given figure for full wave rectifier. Here they given the turns ratio. This is the turns ratio. This is a primary winding. This is a secondary winding. 5:1 they given. That is N2 by N1, right? So this will be your VI 230 volt they given, plus and minus. It's a center tape transformer. So this will be off VM. This is one more VM actually. It's an ideal diode, keep it in mind. So here we are considering the ideal diode. This will be your RL. They given 100. So what they ask you to calculate? So you have to assume that diodes are ideal. Means RF is equal to 0. That is the meaning of that. Yes, sure. I will send the numericals along with the answers I'll send, because I'm not going to solve so many problems. I will send the set of problems you try to solve. Okay. So you can try to solve from your end. So that is RF is equal to 0. So let me solve that. Yes, see, now the primary to secondary turn ratio, that is N1 by N2, is nothing but primary to secondary turn ratio, that is N1 by N2, means N1 by N2 is equal to, that is N1, that is what turn ratio, N1:N2, okay, that is nothing but 5 by 1. So that will be the RMS primary voltage will be 230. That is given here. RMS primary. This is the prime. RMS means, always remember, RMS stands for root mean square. Okay. Root mean square, the primary voltage is 230 volt. That is RMS secondary voltage. See here, RMS secondary voltage will be how much? So already we seen previous how to calculate. That is the RMS primary voltage 230. That is nothing but RMS primary voltage. Mean I will call as PI, PP. Okay. This I will call as VS. Example I'm saying. Okay. So VS is equal to VP into N1 by N2. N1 by N2. So already we know that the turns per ratio, right? Sorry, N, not N, sorry. That is N2 by N1. Formula is this. VP into N2 by N1, where N2 is 1, N is 5. That will become as 46 volt.
So here I am giving 230 volt as input. Here in this place, I am getting
how much voltage I am getting?
46 volt. I am getting means your transformer will step down this 230 to
46 volt. Now, what will be the maximum voltage across the secondary? Now, we have to say complete across. That is nothing but 46. This 46 is nothing but not completely. This is one portion. Okay, and that is one portion only I'm getting. So means not a two ends, one end. So it will be 46 into root 2. That will be 65 volts. So totally I'm giving, that is right, 65 volt will be your output of that. Now the maximum voltage across the half-wave secondary winding will be Vm is equal to 65 by 2. That is the maximum voltage across the half-secondary. Now what will be the maximum? That is Vm. This Vm, that is the maximum. What I'll get is 65 by 2 means 32.5. Here this will be your 32.5. Here also will be 32.5 will get. So now we have to find out what you have to find out. See, first thing is you have to find out DC output voltage. Then this is nothing but DC output voltage means what? It is a VDC. We have to find out the VDC. Okay, VDC. Then PIP. That is the peak inverse voltage. Then we have to calculate the efficiency. These are the things we need to calculate. So first, let us calculate average IDC. So the average IDC will be that is something but I average, or I can say IDC. That is I average or IDC for full wave rectifier. What is the formula? I average is equal to, that is I average, right? I average is equal to 2Vm by pi RL. So is equal to, see, you may think, you may ask where is RF here, because as I said, this is ideal case. So if it is ideal case, actually this formula will become as like this, 2Vm by pi into RF plus RL actually. But RF is equal to zero due to, we are considering it's an ideal diode. In the question they mentioned, assumed to be ideal, that is zero internal resistance. So what happened? The RF will be eliminated. The RF will be eliminated. That is the formula will come like this. Substitute the corresponding value, we'll get 0.207 ampere. Next, second, they ask you to calculate the PIB. That is nothing but what? Peak inverse voltage. So how much the peak inverse voltage will get here? The peak inverse voltage will be is equal to the maximum secondary voltage. What is the maximum secondary voltage? Already we got, that is nothing but 65 volt. That only is nothing but your peak inverse voltage. Next, third, they ask you to calculate efficiency. So what is the efficiency of full wave rectifier? As we calculated in the derivation, theoretical part we done. I hope you remember that. So that is the efficiency. What is the formula for efficiency? That is eta is equal to PDC divided by PAC, right? That is nothing but eta will be equal to PDC. What is the PDC? Power delivered. That is a DC power. That is nothing but 0.812. That is, you can calculate from here end. What is PDC? We know the formula. So which are the value we are having here? We are having IDC, No. So just IDC you have to calculate. PDC is equal to I square DC we can calculate. IDC, I square DC into RL we can calculate. Or you can use the formula as PDC is equal to the output, that is VDC by RL. Or you can use VDC by RL. Where VDC is nothing but you can use that kind of formula also. Use the formula. Since the RF is equal to zero, the formula will be given. Just to substitute in this formula, we'll get the efficiency as 81.2%. See here, this is what in the theoretical we calculated, like how much the rectification we got for full wave rectifier.